I had a litany of health complications from sickle cell disease. Acute chest syndrome, pneumonia, pulmonary embolisms, those were like almost a constant. I like equating it to a succession of time bombs, what it feels like living with sickle cell and having all these complications. And it was gonna take me away from the father I've always wanted to be. It really played a role in every facet of my life, in what I wanted to become. It kind of was like a dream killer, I would call it. Over the course of my life, I would say I've probably had over 200 blood transfusions. My wife has been like fantastic and probably another reason why I'm still here. Many times this woman was literally the person standing in the middle between me and the doctors, making sure that I get the treatment that I deserved.
As a white person, you don't realize the difference in treatment for somebody who's a person of color until you're right there watching it happen in front of you. It's jarring, and it makes you so angry that it's happening to the person that you love the most in this world. We are not just a number. We are not just, you know, a patient. We are a person.
I got an article in my inbox about the first person to alleviate the symptoms of a sickle cell through gene therapy. There was one line that really caught me that I'll never forget till this day. And that line was like, I can go to my son's basketball game. That was all I needed to, you know, to give him that push to sign up for the clinical trial. And immediately my wife called the research team that was running that clinical trial, and the next day they called back.
And he said he got our message and we're interested, and let's go ahead and get this ball rolling.
First part of this clinical trial is something called keeping you on ice. And what they mean is basically keeping you healthy, because you still have sickle cell disease, but you have to be healthy enough to go through this clinical trial. So what gene therapy involves is collecting your stem cells through your bone marrow, and those stem cells are then edited to produce hemoglobin F. Many times my hemoglobin was so low, doctors are like literally asking me, how are you still walking? You know, so there's a chance that I wouldn't have even gotten there if I didn't have people donating blood to save my life.
The first time when we were in the trial that Jimi had his first blood exchange, he was skipping down the hallway to get home, and he kind of stopped at the end of the hallway and looked at me and said, is this how normal people feel every day?
My quality of life has improved tremendously since receiving gene therapy. I think the most important one is obviously the lack of pain. It's just completely gone.
What I would say to the donors who've helped Jimi through this process is, we could not be here without you. You've supported us throughout the trial, and I can never repay you for what you've done for us.
Blood donations played a very crucial role in my pre and post transplant process. Without blood donations, I would never be able to get to that place to get my genes edited. So I'm thinking, you did not only save my life, you saved my generation. Now I have a son, and God willing, my son will have children as well. And that's because of the small act of just donating blood. You're literally saving someone's life.